had I a golden thread and needle so fine, I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design. Of rainbow design. Far over the waters I'd reach my magic band to every human being, so they would understand, so they'd understand. Of silk and shoes of bright green leather, but I would give them all for my handsome, winsome Johnny. Some say he's bad, but I say he's bonny, fairest of them all is my handsome, winsome Johnny. I know where I'm going, and I know going with me. I know who I love, but the devil knows who I'll marry.
An old, old, old song. Scotland, they say. Oh, Ireland, I don't know. Maybe it is Ireland. But I sang it for a reason. Two very wonderful young people I've asked to come around and visit me on this program. I don't see them very often. We pass each other like traveling musicians will. Last summer, I'll never forget hearing them sing at the Newport Folk Festival. Dick Fariña had a dulcimer on his knee, and Mimi, his wife, playing the guitar, and they had some other instruments playing with them, and they were going it hot and heavy. It was middle of the afternoon, and 7,000 people had been sitting out there in the hot sun, getting hotter and hotter, perspiration dripping down, and all of a sudden, the sky gets dark, and one of these sudden summer thunder showers came along. Rain just poured down, and Dick and Mimi, having just gotten on the stage, decided to keep on playing. Someone put an umbrella over them to keep the instruments dry. And 7,000 people up front, they'd been waiting to hear them. They weren't going to leave. Well, I was standing backstage, and I peeked through the curtain there, and I saw a sight I'll never forget in all my life. 7,000 people were getting soaking wet, and they said, "What the heck? Let's get wet." They started stripping off their clothing and dancing to the music. It was a real rocking number with wonderful rhythm going. And there were people, men waving their shirts in the air and dancing all kinds of dances. Women had stripped off their shirts, dancing in their bras. It was a pandemonium, 7,000 people dancing in the thundering rain, and Dick and Mimi pounding on. It was wonderful. And I actually haven't heard them sing since then. So I'm looking forward to this program. They sing a lot of different kinds of songs, some old ones, but they also sing new ones. Dick is a very talented writer. He's written a novel being published this year. And he turns out song after song. And so we try them out. Maybe they'll try some new ones out on us. Who knows? It's interesting how this songwriting bit got started. I don't know how it got started. People have always been making up songs. But 20 or 30 years ago, people thought folk songs were just old songs. Then along came this fellow Woody Guthrie, who had the habit of taking an old song and adding new verses to it, like this, for example. I gotta shift gears. You got to walk that lonesome valley. You got to walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here can walk it for you. You got to walk it by yourself. Now the old song went like that, and the only verse change there was to say, Mama's gotta walk that lonesome valley, or Papa's gotta walk that lonesome valley, or Sister's gotta walk that lonesome valley, or you gotta walk that lonesome valley, or I gotta walk that lonesome valley. But Woody started making up new verses. Daniel was a Bible hero, was a prophet, brave and true, in a den of hungry lions. He showed what faith can do for you. Now you got to walk that lonesome valley, you got to walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here can walk it for you. You got to walk it by yourself. Now though the road be rough and rocky, and the hills be steep and high, we can sing as we go marching, and we'll win that one big union by and by. Oh, so you can't sit down for this. You got to walk that lonesome valley. You got to walk by yourself. Ain't nobody here can walk it for you. You got to walk it by yourself. So anyway, the same as Woody would take over an old song and put new words to it, other people would do it too. And then we realized this is what folk musicians had been doing for hundreds and thousands of years. And other people started writing songs. Now there's a whole flood of songwriters. Bob Dylan, Tom Paxton, Phil Oakes, and Malvina Reynolds, and even me been trying to write some songs, and all kinds of people been trying to write songs, whether they can or not. And I figure it's a good thing. You know, the apex of a pyramid is as high as the base is broad. If you get lots of people writing songs, you're gonna get a few very good songs. Maybe 999,999 out of a million will be forgot. Next year, 20 years from now, you'll have to go to a library to find them. But one song may be remembered by our grandchildren's grandchildren. Who knows? So, I'm making up new songs. It's for another reason. You see, we're living right here and now. Sometimes I face a whole crowd of people, and I'm trying to say something that's on my mind, and no old song I know can say it exactly like I want to say it. I look for an old song to say it, I can't find it. So I start making up a new song of my own. Well, I'll sing one in just a moment, but let me go ask Mimi and Dick to come here and join us. We'll pour out coffee. Friends, pull up a chair, sit down, make yourself comfortable, as I am. And I'd like to introduce you to Dick Fariña and Mimi Fariña, two lovely young people, and I'm just going to sit back and listen myself. first I was waiting for you to start singing, and then I realized the whole point of it was the rhythm, and I couldn't keep still. I hope you don't mind my joining in.
No, you wanted that to happen. I meant to tell you even beforehand.
It would take a dead man not to move on that.
I'm going to do a song that I wrote with Mimi's sister Pauline that you know parts of, called Pack Up Your Sorrows, and we'd like you to play it with us, or sing it with us, whatever you like.
Okay. Pack up your sorrows.
Pack up your sorrows. In fact, if people out there would like to sing with us, the words go something like, if somehow you could pack up your sorrows and give them all to me, you would lose them. I know how to use them. Give them all to me. We'll play a little first, huh? Give them all to me. You would lose them. I know how to use them. Give them all to me. Pauline wrote that. It's kind of unselfish.
If somehow you could pack up your sorrows and give them all to me, you would lose them. I know how to use them. Give them all to me.
And no use gambling, running darkness, seeking out a satisfied mind. Too many highways, too many byways, and nobody's walking behind. Ah, but it's somehow
you can pack up your sorrows and give them all to me. You
song. I saw that printed in Sing Out magazine. I hope people will pick it up. And I hadn't, you know, it's hard though to learn a song from a piece of paper, and I'd leafed it by, and I say, well, now sometime I got to look at it because I like the words and I heard it sung, but I hadn't gotten around to memorizing. I will now.
Okay.
You have to retune again?
Just slightly.
While he's retuning, let me ask you a question. What are you doing these days?
Me? I'm singing and dancing.
Good. It's what people should do. Are you traveling?
Yes, traveling together. On the East Coast for a little while. And we live in California. Carmel. So we bake in the sun there for a while.
Oh, you luckies.
And come out here and show it off and go back there and bake in the sun some more.
Isn't the one time I was out there, the water was awfully cold, is it?
It's very cold, yeah. Our dog swims in it.
Beautiful country, though. I wonder how many of you viewing have even seen pictures of the coast around Carmel, California. It's only in the last few years they've had roads there, because the mountains tumble down into the sea and pine trees cling to the rocks. And the Pacific Ocean sometimes is full of fog and rolls up, but then it gets up to the top of the hill and all of a sudden the fog evaporates as soon as it gets to the top of the hill. And when it does clear off, why, you get the most magnificent views you could imagine. It's one of the most lovely parts of America, and I think one of the most lovely parts of the whole world, too. You're lucky people to live there.
This is a song called The Bold Marauder. I'm fond of dedicating it to the memory of Barry Goldwater, sometimes to the memory of Ronald Reagan. It's really meant for almost anybody who feels that because they have the various gods and presidents on their side, they can send their armies marauding over the earth.
Thank you.
It's high, ho, hey. I am the boner otter, and high, ho, hey. I am the white destroyer, for I will sour the winds on high, and I will soil the river, and I will burn. Ravage and kill, and I will go to thunder, and I will take a fury to wife, and I will be your father, and death will be our darling, and fear will be our name.
Dick and Mimi Fariña have got a lot more songs, so stick around a moment and we'll be back. I want to find out more about how you got playing the dulcimer, too. You're this traditional instrument you're playing in a new way, combining two or three old traditions, aren't you? Well, we'll talk about it later, just a minute. Dick, as I see you playing that dulcimer there, Kentucky Mountain dulcimer, which was only supposed to be played traditionally. Now I see you're playing counter rhythms to Mimi. You'll be playing in 6/8 time, and she'll be playing in 3/4 time, or vice versa, and here we go. And then you start accelerating the tempo as though you were playing an Indian sitar. And it puts me in mind of the fact this is going to happen all around the world, for good or bad. And my guess is that the good combinations will last and the bad combinations will be forgotten, I hope. You know this language that we speak is part German, part Latin, and part Greek, with some Celtic and Arabic all in the heap, well amended by the man in the street. Choctaw gave us the word okay, vamos is a word from Mexico way. And all of this is a hint, I suspect, of what comes next. I think that this whole world, soon, mama, my whole wide world, soon, mama, my whole world, soon gonna be get mixed up. You can play the maracas on that. I like Polish sausage, I like Spanish rice. Pizza pie is also nice. Corn and beans from the Indians here, washed down by some German beer. Marco Polo traveled by camel and pony, brought to Italy the first macaroni. And you and I, as well as we're able, put it all on the table. I think that this whole world, soon, mama, my whole wide world, soon, mama, my whole world, soon gonna be get mixed up. There were no red-headed Irishmen before the Vikings landed in Ireland. How many Romans had dark curly hair before they brought slaves from Africa? No race of man is completely pure, nor is any man's mind, and that's for sure. The winds mix the dust of every land, and so will man. I think that this whole world, soon, mama, my whole wide world, soon, mama, my whole world, soon gonna be get mixed up. Oh, this doesn't mean we must all be the same. We'll have different faces and different names. Long live many different kinds of races, and difference of opinion that makes horse races. Just remember the rule about rules, brother. What's right with one is wrong with another. And take a tip from La Belle France. Vive la de France. I think that this whole world, soon, mama, my whole wide world, soon, mama, my whole world, soon gonna be get mixed up. This whole world, soon, mama, my whole wide world, soon, mama, my whole world, soon gonna be get mixed up. Ah, now it's your turn.
Okay, we're gonna do a song about a fellow we heard about, who was having a lot of trouble during the election year with his dreams. Kept mixing up the various presidential candidates in his mind. Kept seeing a lot of waves and wax and women Marines walking around carrying bagfuls of chocolate-covered donuts and whatnot. And everything was confusing. He figured the country was responsible. He needed a vacation in the sun, but he didn't have any money. It was going to be a war on poverty. So he took the only free trip he could get, which was to Cuba at that time. And there was a message waiting for him in the box at the American Express, which is where everybody goes when they get to Cuba. And he went back to the House on American Activities Committee, and as you probably read in the paper, when he was up before the stand, somebody jumped out of the gallery wearing the equivalent of a Superman costume. He's a member of George Lincoln Rockwell's American Nazi Party, in fact, and tried to strangle this fellow who had gone to Cuba. That was in the New York Times. And got him unconscious, and while he was unconscious, he and a whole bunch of other people were cited for contempt of court, and I thought the whole thing was, ha-ha, very funny. So I made up a song about it, and it's called The House on American Blues Activity Dream. This is all dream music.
Sidewalk had a noise in my head. There were loudspeakers babbling, but nothing was said. There were 27 companies of female Marines. There were presidential candidates, new Levi jeans. It was the red, white, and blue, and how to endure the fife, drum, and bugle marching down on the poor. God bless America without any doubt, and I figured it was time to get out. Well, I had to flee the in-between scene. Good people went and got undone in the sun. Good people, tourist information said to get on the stick. You ain't moving till you're grooving with a Cuban and a chick. So I hopped on a plane, took a pill from my brain. I discovered I was feeling all right. When I strolled down the Prado, people looked at me weird. Who's that hippie hoppy character without any beard? Drinking juice from papaya, singing songs to the trees. Dancing mambo on the beaches, spreading social disease. Now that Castro convertible was changing the style. A whole lot of action on a blockaded aisle. When along come a summons in the middle of night, saying, buddy, we're about to indict. If they ask you a question, they expect a reply. Doesn't matter if you're fixing a die. Well, I was lying there unconscious, feeling kind of exempt, when the judge said that silence was a sign of contempt. He took out his gavel, banged me hard on the head. He fined me 10. on a pile of manure. Say your prayers and the pledge of allegiance every night, and tomorrow you'll be feeling all right.
A dream? You're still out of jail, I see.
Oh, you know, we do our best.
I think you can gather that Dick here is a poet, basically. And you'd have to hear these songs several times over to start hearing all the meanings in his words. Of course, this is true of Bob Dylan, too, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely.
It's one reason I like songs that even some of the old folk songs are like this. You hear them over and over again, and you get new meanings, new ideas out of them. It's not as though there's any one meaning to anything, but as life teaches you a little bit more, it shines new light on this little song. Well, I'm very glad you're writing songs. I don't know how you feel out there, but I am. I'd love to hear you.
There are some people who just as soon have us keep quiet, bake in the sun, walk the dog. Sure.
Well, you don't just bake in the sun out there in California, I understand.
No, there's Mimi's sister, Joni, has a school, an institute for the study of nonviolent action. And since it started out last August, we've been out there working on that. Mimi teaching dance classes, me cooking, and everyone else trying to learn, including ourselves. It's basically a six-week course in the study of the philosophy of nonviolence. There's been a lot of
Thoreau and Gandhi and so on.
That's right, and a little of the opposition as well. It's an attempt to find out if nonviolent action is a working alternative to the chaos that we're bringing down around our heads every day somewhere in the world. And it's not a school that teaches civil disobedience or teaches how to walk on a picket line or any of that. Well, there are schools set up for that elsewhere, and the need for them does exist. But this particular school is just trying to get at the philosophy. You wouldn't know that from the response of the people in the area. We're smack in the middle of an essentially military community, four-doored, with 36,000 trainees at any given moment. And a lot of other people who feel that the very presence of the school is an insult to the military and political policies of the country. So from its very inception, we've been getting a lot of harassment and haven't had so much as one running week when we haven't been visited either by the police or by lawyers or by neighbors, or getting signs stuck on our cars, or occasionally threatening letters stuck in mailboxes, that kind of thing.
I think it was George Bernard Shaw who said when Gandhi was assassinated, he said, it's a very dangerous thing to try and be peaceful.
There was a woman who stood up, in fact, at a hearing that was being held by the local board of supervisors deciding whether or not the school was, in fact, a school and whether they should be allowed to conduct classes and whether the zoning was proper. For a while, that is classified as a business and then as a nonprofit organization and finally as a school. But a woman stood up and said, "The Institute for the Study of Nonviolent Action, the very name is suspicious," and got applauded as she sat down. Another man stood up and said, "Nonviolence. Nonviolence can only lead to more violence." and so on and so on.
That reminds me of a joke from the way back in the Depression days, the 30s, when there was supposed to be a demonstration down in Union Square, New York, and the policeman comes along with his club, and the guy raises up his hand and says, "But I'm an anti-communist." And the policeman says, "I don't care what kind of a communist you are." How'd we get on this subject? The reason is that songs are not just to do about with flowers and birds and the ocean, but songs have to do with everything in life, whether it's an old ballad or a work song or a love song. And so it's quite natural that young people making up songs today are making up about what's going on in the world today. Do we have time for another song or so before the end? I tell you, let's take a break, then we'll have time. Tell you what, in addition to making up songs about, the the universal problems that mankind faces, I hope people also make up all kinds of little ditties about just what goes on in their community or in their family. Like Malvina Reynolds will make up a song for her neighbor's children. And some of the best folk songs I know must have been made up this same way. Well, here's a New York State song, since you're from California. 100 years ago, maybe. A gay and handsome traveling man lay on a bed of pain. All hope was past, his life ebbed fast, he ne'er would rise again. Have you no sweetheart fair and true? They whispered o'er his bed. Whom you would tell a last farewell, the young man softly said. There's Daisy back in Warrensburg, and Bess in Sandy Hill. There's Millie down in Albany, and Kate in Mechanicville. There's darling Bess in good old Ty, and Mary up in Jay. And write to Sue in Rutland too, or will be to pay. The watchers stared in wild surprise, and then they said once more, and tell us, pray, without delay, the girl whom you adore. The girl whom you have sworn to love and bring both wealth and fame. You are promised wife and hope and life. Quick, let us know her name. In Saratoga, Jenny lives. Go phone her quick, he said. And Carrie calls from dear Glens Falls, and Anne from Old Fort Head. There's Mamie down in Old Fort Anne, and Maudie in Whitehall. The young man sighed, it's time I died, I've sworn to love 'em all. It's not deathless poetry, but the reason I sung it, partly a friend sent the song to me last week in a letter, but the idea that you could make up songs about any occasion, about your home locality, and not every song has to last forever. And I think also there ought to be more songs just giving people a sense of the fun you can have out of life. I myself am making up too many sad and grim, sorrowful songs. You got some joyous ones?
Yeah, I've got one coming right up. Song, as a matter of fact, you can play on this one too. It's in the key of G, I do believe. Upside down. There were penguins in the breeze, politicians in the trees, and the hummingbirds were flying upside down. Bop, 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 bop. I got joy around my brain. Joy around my brain. Wait and see, my
off their clothes. Lord, the congressmen were tearing off their clothes. There were red and white and blue and black balloons. There were foreign subversive caravans running all over the moon. And the congressmen were tearing off their clothes.
Now, the reason I feel that you got to have joyous songs is you start saying that the world has gone to the devil and there's no hope and everything, and pretty soon people like feel like giving up. And I feel that the main job of a musician in this world is to give people the feeling you got to fight, keep on going, not give up, no matter what happens. In a way, you might say my slogan is, because I'm so pessimistic, I go around trying to cheer people up. And sometimes an old song, let's end off with an old one, key of D, can have as much meaning as any new one. Now, maybe I'm wrong, but this could be even an epitaph for all our endeavors. Well, it's love, love, oh, careless love. Love, love, oh, careless love. Love, oh, love, oh, careless love. Can't you see what love has done to me? Well, I love my mom and papa too. Sing it with me. Love my mom and papa too. Love my mom and papa too. And I'll leave them both to go with you. Sing it with us. Love, oh, careless love. Love. Shock you too much, but you ain't heard nothing yet. My advice is, if you like music, you got to learn to make it yourself, so you're welcome to sing along. Well, it's love, 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 oh, careless love. So fine, I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. In it I'd weave the bravery of women giving birth. In it I'd weave the innocence of children over all the earth, children of all earth, far over the waters,
my magic band. To every city, through every single land, through every land. Show my brothers and my sisters my rainbow design. Bind up this old world with hand and heart and mind.